So, dear students, in the last class we have started to learn something about organic chemistry. So, as I have told you in the last class, organic chemistry is the branch of chemistry which deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. Is the latest definition of organic chemistry. So today we will study broadly how organic compounds are classified into. So classification of organic compounds. So an organic compound is classified broadly into two types. Number one, alicyclic or open chain compounds. These compounds are also called as aliphatic compounds. So broadly, organic compounds is classified into alicyclic and cyclic. Acyclic and cyclic compounds. Acyclic compounds are also called as open chain compounds. They are also called as aliphatic compounds. So another type of compound is cyclic compounds or ring compounds or closed chain compounds. So organic compounds are broadly classified into open chain compounds, closed chain compounds. Open chain compounds are also called as acyclic compounds or aliphatic compounds. Closed chain compounds are also called as ring compounds or closed chain compounds. So what is the meaning of acyclic or open chain compounds? Here in these compounds, the carbon atoms are linked to one another to form a long chain or branched chains. So acyclic compounds or open chain compounds are the organic compounds in which the carbon atoms are linked to one another either to form a long chain or to form a branched chain are called acyclic compounds. So here the carbon atoms in these compounds, there is a ring or closed chain of carbon atoms. Compounds containing a ring of carbon atoms or closed chain carbon atoms are called cyclic or ring or closed chain compounds. So again, these cyclic compounds are classified into two types, homocyclic and heterocyclic. Homocyclic compounds, these are the cyclic compounds which contain rings or cycles or closed chain carbon atoms. So if that ring contains, or if the closed chain contains only carbon atoms, they are called homocyclic compounds. On the other hand, in that ring, if the ring contains other atoms like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, these are called heteroatoms. They are called heterocyclic compounds. If the organic compounds rings, they are called ring or closed chain compounds, ring of carbon atoms. If an organic compound contains a ring of carbon atom or closed chain carbon atoms, they are called cyclic or ring or closed chain compounds. If the ring contain only carbon atoms, they are called homocyclic. On the other hand, if the ring contains one or two heteroatoms like nitrogen, oxygen or sulfur, they are called heterocyclic compounds. In both the compounds, there is a ring. If the ring contains only carbon atoms, they are called homocyclic compound. If the ring contains nitrogen or oxygen or sulfur in addition to carbon atoms, they are called as heterocyclic compounds. In homocyclic compounds, there are two types, allicyclic and aromatic. What are allicyclic compounds? These are the cyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. Even though they are cyclic compounds, their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. Such cyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons are called allicyclic compounds. So these are the aromatic compounds. These are the cyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons. So in your later classes, you will going to know what are aliphatic hydrocarbons and aromatic hydrocarbons, etc. So aromatic compounds containing one or more benzene rings are called aromatic compounds. In heterocyclic compounds, again there are two types, allicyclic, heterocyclic compounds. These are the heterocyclic compounds, cyclic compounds containing hetero atoms and whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons are called allicyclic, heterocyclic compounds. And then what are aromatic heterocyclic compounds? These are the heterocyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons are called aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So this is how organic compounds are broadly classified into these types. So first write down this chart and later on I will explain what are allicyclic, cyclic, etc. So write down organic compound, acyclic or open chain compounds, they are also called as aliphatic compounds. Another type, cyclic or ring or closed chain compounds. So in acyclic compounds, acyclic compounds, again there are three types, alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Alkanes are represented by the general formula CnH2n+2. The alkenes are represented by the general formula CnH2n. Alkynes are represented by the general formula CnH2n-2, where n is an integer like 1, 2, 3, etc. Suppose if n equals 1, C1H4, what is this compound? This compound is called methane. When n equals 2, it is called C2H6, this is called ethane, etc. So similarly, when n equals 1, C1H2, so it is unstable. If n equals 2, C2H4, this is called ethene. So when n equals to C2H2, this is called ethane. The first compound is unstable here in this series. So in cyclic or ring compounds, again there are two types, homocyclic compounds and heterocyclic compounds. Homocyclic compounds and heterocyclic compounds. So in homocyclic compounds, again there are two types: acyclic compounds, alicyclic compounds and aromatic compounds. So in heterocyclic compounds, these are the compounds whose ring contain at least one or two nitrogen, oxygen or sulfur atoms. So again there are two types: alicyclic heterocyclic compounds. Here it is aromatic heterocyclic compounds. Aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So this is the chart showing the broad classification of organic compounds. Now let us study one by one. In one sentence, later on we will study in detail in your classes. First we will know acyclic or open chain or aliphatic hydrocarbons. Aliphatic compounds. Acyclic or open chain or aliphatic compounds. So what is the meaning of this one? What is the definition of this one? Acyclic open chain or aliphatic compounds. Compounds, write down, organic compounds in which the carbon atoms are linked to one another. Organic compounds in which the carbon atoms are linked to one another to form a long chain or branched chain. Long chain or branched chain are called open chain acyclic or open chain compounds. Compounds in which the carbon atoms are linked to one another to form a long chain or branched chain is called an acyclic compound. Open chain compounds, they are also called as aliphatic compounds. Example, CH3, CH2, CH3. So how this compound is represented as CH3, CH2, CH3. What is the valency of carbon? Valency of carbon is 4. See here 1H, 1H, 1H. There is another bond. This bond is connected to this carbon. Here it is one bond, H, and here this one is H. So around carbon atom there are 4 covalent bonds. So this compound CH3, CH2, CH3. This compound is called propane. This is the molecular formula and this one is the structural formula. So you have to bear in your mind that the valency of carbon is 4. So it can combine with 4 other atoms. So valency of carbon 4, it's also 4, it is also 4. It is combined with 3 other hydrogen atoms and 1 carbon atom, 2 other hydrogen atoms and 2 carbon atoms. three other hydrogen atoms and one carbon atom. So this is the formula, molecular formula of propane, and this is the structural formula. So what is this compound? Example, propane. This is molecular formula, and this one is structural formula. This one is propane. So it is a carbon atoms linked to one another to form a chain, long chain. Or other hand, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. So if it undergoes branching here by removing one hydrogen, so this becomes CH3 is propane. If one hydrogen atom is removed, another methyl group is added. This is called isobutane in common name. This is called isobutane in IUPAC name. We will discuss the naming of organic compounds in detail later on. So this is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So for the second carbon atom, one methyl group is attached. This is also called as longest carbon is taken. Propane 1. So this one is propane, 1 methyl propane, or propane 1 methyl. It is also called as 2 methyl propane, because methyl group is attached to second carbon of propane. So it is called 2-methyl propane. This is the IUPAC name. We will discuss it later on. So these are aliphatic hydrocarbons. Aliphatic hydrocarbons are again classified into 3 types, namely alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Aliphatic hydrocarbons. Aliphatic hydrocarbons are again classified into 3 types. Number 1, alkanes. Number 2, alkenes. Number 3, alkynes. So first we will know what is alkanes. Alkanes are the saturated aliphatic so aliphatic hydrocarbons are again classified into 3 types. Number 1, again, so before that I will classify again these aliphatic hydrocarbons into 2 types. Again classified into 2 types. Number 1, saturated aliphatic hydrocarbons. And they are also called as alkanes. Number 2, unsaturated aliphatic hydrocarbons. Again, they are classified into alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes and alkynes. So, aliphatic hydrocarbons classified into two types: saturated aliphatic hydrocarbons and unsaturated aliphatic hydrocarbons. Aliphatic hydrocarbons. They are also called as open chain compounds. They are classified into saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons are also called as alkanes. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are again classified into two types: alkenes and alkynes. So, in alkanes, there is a single bond between two carbon atoms. In alkenes, there is a single double bond, at least a single double bond between two carbon atoms. Alkynes, there is at least one triple bond between two carbon atoms. So, compounds containing carbon-carbon single bonds are called alkanes. Alkenes are the compounds contain at least one double bond between the carbon atoms. Alkynes are the compounds which contain at least one triple bond between two carbon atoms. So, general formula of alkanes is CnH2n+2. Their alkenes general formula is CnH2n, and their general formula is CnH2n-2, where n is an integer, where n is an integer, So, we will study in detail while studying hydrocarbons. Okay. So, acyclic or open chain are aliphatic hydrocarbons in which carbon atoms are linked to one another, to form a long chain or branched chain, are called aliphatic, are called acyclic or open chain compounds. They are also called as aliphatic hydrocarbons. Again, they are classified into two types, namely saturated and unsaturated. Saturated compounds containing carbon-carbon single bond. Unsaturated contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond, and they are called alkenes. And alkynes, in which the compounds contain at least one triple bond between two carbon atoms. So, and then now we'll study cyclic or ring. Or closed chain compounds. Cyclic, ring, or closed chain compounds. So, what are they are called? Compounds which contains rings or closed chain of carbon atoms are called closed chain compounds. They are of two types. Number one, homocyclic compounds, and number two, heterocyclic compounds. First, we will know what are homocyclic compounds. Homocyclic compounds. They are the cyclic compounds. They are the cyclic compounds which contain only carbon atoms in their rings. Only carbon atoms in their rings. Next, homocyclic compounds are classified into number one, acyclic compounds, and number two, aromatic compounds. Acyclic compounds and number two, aromatic compounds. They are not acyclic, they are alicyclic compounds. Alicyclic compounds and aromatic compounds. What are alicyclic compounds? Alicyclic compounds. Alicyclic compounds. These are the cyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. These are the cyclic compounds. Even though they are cyclic compounds, their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. Example, cyclopropane. So CH2, and this one, cyclopropane. CH2 is called cyclopropane, or it can also be simply written like this, cyclopropane. Number two, cyclobutane. CH2 like this. This is cyclobutane, or it can be written only like this. This is cyclobutane. Similarly, cyclopentane. CH2. So, CH2, so there are 5 carbon atoms, therefore it is called cyclopentane. So, or it can be written like this. So, this is cyclopentane. Similarly, lastly, cyclohexane. CH2. So, or its structure can be written like this. So, this is cyclohexane. So, even though they are ring or closed chain compounds, their properties are similar to open chain compounds, namely alkanes. Therefore, they are called as alicyclic compounds. Ali means they behave like aliphatic hydrocarbons and also they contain rings. Therefore, they are called alicyclic compounds. So, ring compounds, compounds containing rings are chain of closed chain of carbon atoms, closed chains of atoms are called cyclic or ring compounds. Again, they are classified into two types, homocyclic and heterocyclic. Homocyclic means if the ring contains only carbon atoms, they are called homocyclic compounds. So, again these homocyclic compounds are classified into two types, alicyclic and aromatic. So, if the properties of these compounds are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons, they are called alicyclic compounds. If the properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons or compounds containing at least one benzene ring are called aromatic compounds. So, now we will study what are aromatic compounds. Homocyclic compounds and homocyclically again alicyclic and aromatic compounds. Aromatic compounds. Aromatic compounds are also called as cyclic compounds. Write down. Cyclic compounds whose properties are similar to the aromatic compounds are compounds containing benzene rings are called aromatic compounds. So, they are also compounds containing rings. Example, C6H6. So, this is benzene. What is its structural formula? So, this is the structural formula of benzene. C6H6, benzene. And then naphthalene. So, if two benzene rings are linked like this, this is called naphthalene. And phenol. So, this is the benzene ring. So, if OH group is attached to here, it is called naphthalene. This is benzene, naphthalene, phenol. So, what is the formula of phenol? C6H6 is benzene, if one nitrogen atom is removed and one OH group is added, it is called C6H5OH. This is the formula of phenol. So coming to naphthalene, how many carbon atoms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is C10. How many hydrogen atoms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. C10H8. So this is the molecular formula of naphthalene. So these are the inhomocyclic compound. There are two types. One is allocyclic and another one is aromatic. In allocyclic compounds, they are also rings, compounds containing rings, but their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. So in aromatic hydrocarbons, they are also cyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons, and also these compounds contain at least one benzene ring. Examples: benzene, naphthalene, phenol, etc. are aromatic cyclic compounds. Then what is the second category in cyclic compounds? So second category is heterocyclic compounds. So heterocyclic compounds are nothing but the cyclic compounds in which the cycle or the ring contain at least one or two hetero atoms like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, etc. Cyclic compounds which contain one or more hetero atoms like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, etc. in their rings are called heterocyclic compounds. So in heterocyclic compounds, there are two types. They are of two types. Number one, allocyclic heterocyclic compounds. Number two, aromatic heterocyclic compounds. First, we will know what are allocyclic heterocyclic compounds. So heterocyclic compounds means they contain one or more hetero atoms in their ring, and also their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons are called allocyclic heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons hydrocarbons are called heterocyclic are called heterocyclic compounds. So example, here it is oxygen atom, this is called tetrahydrofuran. So CH2, 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 this is O, this is oxygen atom. So they contain one oxygen atom in the ring, tetrahydrofuran. This is called tetrahydrofuran. And I will give you another example. NH. This is piperidine. This is piperidine. Piperidine. These are the some of the examples of allocyclic, and these are the cyclic compounds containing at least one heteroatom and whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons are called allocyclic heterocyclic compounds. And then coming to aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So hetero, these are the heterocyclic compounds. These are the heterocyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons. So they contain hetero cycles and also their properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons. Example, so this one is furan. FURON. This is furan. Number two, pyrrole, NH. This is furan. So this is pyrrole. This is pyrrole and furan, pyrrole. And number three, pyridine. This is pyridine. So these are all the cyclic compounds, aromatic compounds, and containing hetero atoms in their rings. So therefore they are called heterocyclic aromatic heterocyclic compounds. They are allocyclic heterocyclic compounds. So they contain rings, they contain hetero atoms but their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. They do not contain double bonds. So these compounds behave like aromatic compounds. They contain hetero atoms in their rings, and therefore they are called aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So this is how organic compounds are broadly classified into these types. So organic compounds are broadly classified into open chain compounds and closed chain compounds. Open chain compounds, in which carbon atoms linked to one another to form a long chain or branched chain. Open chain compounds are again classified into two types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated hydrocarbons contain only carbon-carbon single bond. Unsaturated hydrocarbons contains double bond and triple bonds. Again, these unsaturated hydrocarbons are classified into two types, alkenes and alkynes. Single bonded carbon atoms are called alkanes. So saturated, unsaturated. Saturated hydrocarbons are called alkanes. Unsaturated hydrocarbons, again they are classified into alkenes and alkynes. So this we will discuss in detail later on in your regular classes. And then coming to second type of major classification, one is open chain compounds, another one is closed chain compounds. Coming to closed chain compounds, these are the compounds which contain closed chain of atoms or rings in their molecules are called closed chain compounds. In closed chain compounds, again there are two types, homocyclic compounds and heterocyclic compounds. Homocyclic compounds, in homocyclic compounds, the ring of atoms contains only carbon atoms. So again in homocyclic compounds, they are again classified into alicyclic compounds and aromatic compounds. Alicyclic compounds contain rings of carbon atoms, and also their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. And aromatic hydrocarbons are, they contain rings of carbons, at least one benzene ring in their structure, and their properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons. Coming to heterocyclic compounds, these are the cyclic compounds which contain at least one or two hetero atoms like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur in their rings. Again, heterocyclic compounds are classified into two types, alicyclic heterocyclic compounds, aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So aliphatic heterocyclic compounds, these are the heterocyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons, namely this one, furan, piperidine, etc. Even though they are cyclic compounds, even though they contain hetero atoms, their properties are similar to aliphatic hydrocarbons. Therefore, they are called alicyclic heterocyclic compounds. And then another type is aromatic heterocyclic compounds. So these are the heterocyclic compounds whose properties are similar to aromatic hydrocarbons. Example, furan, pyrrole, pyridine, etc. These are the heterocyclic aromatic compounds.